Let us study some facts about direction of Earth's magnetic field. As we have already seen the structure that Earth's magnetic field is due to the rotation of iron alloy particles inside the core of Earth, due to which magnetic field originates from the southern hemisphere of Earth and it terminates on the northern hemisphere. And the magnetic field is oriented in such a way that the magnetic axis of Earth is approximately at an angle 11 degree with respect to the rotation axis of Earth. Now, in this situation, if we specifically analyze the direction at a point on Earth's surface, then in the northern hemisphere, let's consider a point P. And if we just zoom into the picture here, we can see at point P, the direction of Earth's magnetic field is getting into the Earth's surface at an angle theta with the horizontal. And if this is Earth's magnetic field BE, it will have one component BH horizontal and another component BV that is vertical. And in this situation, we can also write here that BH is the BH which is given as BE cos theta. It is the horizontal component of Earth's magnetic field. And here BV, which is BE sin theta, just have resolved into two perpendicular components. This is the vertical component of Earth's magnetic field. At different points on Earth's surface, the angle theta would be different. Here you can see at the north pole, the angle theta will be 90 degree, and at the magnetic equator or the line where Earth's magnetic field is parallel to Earth's surface, the value of theta is 0. This theta we call dip angle, or it is also termed as angle of dip. And this is the diagram I have drawn for a point in northern hemisphere of Earth. And similarly, if I draw a diagram for southern hemisphere of Earth, then here you can see in southern hemisphere, if we consider a point in this picture here, you can see, if we zoom into the picture, you can see at a point the magnetic field is going away from the Earth's surface, B is outward, and at this point, again, there will be a horizontal component and there will be a vertical component with the same values. But the difference in the two situations, you can see here that in northern hemisphere of Earth, a vertical component of magnetic field is vertically downward. And in southern hemisphere of Earth, vertical component of Earth's magnetic field at any point is in vertically upward direction. And you can relate the two components as BV by BH, we can write as tan theta. That is a relation between the two components of Earth's magnetic field. And every point, this BH you can see is in the direction from south to north, because in southern hemisphere the field is originating and in northern hemisphere it is terminating. So we can always write direction of BH at any point is from south to north direction at that point. So you must be careful about these analyses, which are quite helpful in analyzing different problems related to terrestrial magnetism, wherever you need to get the directions of different components of Earth's magnetic field.